Let's go. Gilmour Space has received their launch license from the Australian government. From a post on X, Gilmour Space expects the target launch date to be early December of this year, that's 2024 at the time this video was made, or mid-January of 2025. The Eris rocket will lift off from the Bowen Orbital Spaceport in North Queensland on its maiden flight. Gilmour Space CEO and co-founder stated, "With this green light, we will soon attempt the first orbital test flight of an Australian-made rocket from Australian soil. Our team is assessing the conditions of the permit and will advise on the anticipated launch date for Eris Test Flight 1 in the coming weeks." The launch license was granted by the Australian Space Agency and represents a landmark in Australia's space exploration abilities. The launch license comes with strict conditions, including a 30-day notification period before liftoff. How long does it take to get a launch license? Well, according to the official documentation, it can take 6 months. Although for the first ever launch license issued, it's not surprising it's taken longer. We know from previous statements from Gilmour Space, they were anticipating launching earlier in 2024, then mid-July and then mid-September, but were waiting for the launch permit to be issued. Adam Gilmour said in his interview with ABC News, "I thought we might get the permit in March this year. So every month after that has just been dragging out." He continued, "We do think we've got a good chance of launching at the end of the 30-day period, and we're going to give it a red-hot go." Gilmour said they are planning a party to celebrate the approval before getting back to work. "It's been a very long journey, a very painful journey. A lot of work's gone into this, and everyone's really happy. Despite the delayed approval, they now have the official launch license signed off by the Australian Space Agency, so it's time to get excited. The first ever launch from Australia could happen next month or soon afterwards." Where is Gilmour Space launching from? In March 2024, a significant milestone was reached in Australia's space industry when the Bowen Orbital Spaceport was granted the country's first orbital launch facility license. This approval paves the way for the launch of rockets and satellites into low Earth orbit from the Bowen Orbital Spaceport, marking a historic moment for Australian space exploration. This spaceport is built and operated by Gilmour Space. It is Australia's first licensed orbital spaceport. From this spaceport, missions from 20 to 65 degrees, that's low to mid-inclination equatorial orbits, are possible. Earlier this year, Gilmour's Eris rocket aces wet dress rehearsal. In September 2024, Gilmour Space completed a wet dress rehearsal. This tests all the launch procedures, including everything in a normal launch, except for igniting the engines. In this case, Gilmour Space went up to 10 seconds before launch before ending the test. They have had the vehicle on the launch pad for some time now. Now that the wet dress rehearsal has been completed and the launch license has been issued, there is nothing stopping Gilmour Space from launching the Eris rocket for the first time. This recent wet dress rehearsal test included 40 technicians from Gilmour Space. It tested that the Eris vehicle could be safely loaded with all the propellants needed and progress the countdown clock up to 10 seconds before liftoff. The director of launch vehicles from Gilmour Space said, "Only minor issues were uncovered by the test. These involved two faulty valves and some minor software reconfiguration. These software tweaks are relatively common, especially for new vehicles." Mr. Dahl said, "The full rehearsal validated the performance of critical systems. This was the final major test to validate the readiness of our rocket, ground systems and crew, while allowing us to address any concerns ahead of launch day. At this stage, we expect to resolve all identified issues in the coming weeks. Pending approvals and other unforeseen events, Eris should be ready for launch as soon as we get the green light." In addition to verifying the vehicle could be safely loaded with propellant, the rehearsal validated ground systems and communications with the launch vehicle were tested. Range operations were also fully rehearsed. The rocket and ground systems were operated remotely from the launch control center, 7 kilometers from the launch pad. Airspace temporary restricted areas were activated and ground exclusion zones were maintained. The company also operated 24-hour, 7-day cycles were completed to ensure team readiness and system reliability, which includes the team that will oversee the launch as well as backup team. A Gilmour Space spokesman said the dress rehearsal took longer than an actual launch, with the crew taking a step-by-step approach. Test Flight 1. Gilmour Space Technologies is gearing up for a comprehensive end-to-end test of their entire vehicle, including the hybrid propulsion engine, rocket design, structures, software, and guidance and control systems. This crucial test will also assess the ground support systems and infrastructure. As part of this mission, a test satellite bus will serve as the payload, with the goal of deploying it into low Earth orbit. Gilmour Space does not encourage viewing of this launch, as there is very likely to be delays since it will be the maiden flight of the Eris rocket. However, for local enthusiasts who are eager to witness this historic event, here are some of the best viewing locations. Unfortunately, there will be no live stream of the launch. However, Gilmour Space plans to release video footage of the test flight. We will be sure to cover this exciting development when it happens. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe to see more videos like this on other small startup companies in space. We cover space startups in every area of the space business, such as launch providers, commercial space stations, space tugs, orbital debris removal, and more. See you soon.